Hey guys, this should be a short video. I just wanted to share about a platform that I believe anyone who is interested in programming should be using. Now, if you're new to programming or if you're someone who is just getting started learning a new programming language, then and you understand the basics, so you understand the syntax, you know what are variables, what are data types, what are loops, etc. The next challenge that you might be facing is how do you practice what you have learned? The best way to practice programming is by working on projects. But then, working on projects can be a daunting task, especially if you are a beginner, because how do you identify what sort of projects you should be working on and how do you get started working on a project? An alternative approach would be if there was a platform where you could practice programming. Fortunately for us, there are several such platforms and LeetCode is one of them. So in this video, I'm going to talk about LeetCode. Now, what is LeetCode? LeetCode is a website that can help you to practice programming. There are hundreds and thousands of different problems which you can solve using any of the programming languages. So for example, you might have a problem and you can solve this problem either using Java or Python or JavaScript or PHP or Ruby or any other programming languages. And also you have questions related to SQL. So you can write SQL queries related to in MySQL or Oracle or PostgreSQL or any of the RDBMS that are available. So it's basically a one-stop shop for you to practice your programming skills. The whole idea of LeetCode is to help anyone to clear interviews. So it's basically not a platform to practice programming, but it's a platform to solve problems using any programming language. And this in turn should help you to become better programmers. So the advantage of LeetCode is that LeetCode is generally used by candidates who are attending interviews in Google, Facebook, Amazon, or Microsoft, etc. So you can be rest assured that the quality of questions that are available in LeetCode are really very good. And the second thing is that it's not just about the problems that are available there. You can also see the solutions, and it's not just one solution to a problem. Inside LeetCode solutions tab, you will find different solutions to the same problem, and they will explain you the algorithm behind that and the thinking behind that. So LeetCode can really help you to think like a programmer. Now, let me just show you how you can use LeetCode to write your programs. So in order to use LeetCode, you can just type leetcode.com in your browser, and then you would see the homepage of LeetCode. Here you can just see several tabs. Just click on problems. Once you go into problems, this is where you will see all the different problems that are available, which you can solve using any of the programming languages that you prefer. And if I see here, there are totally 1,877 programs as of today. And I have currently solved only 12 of them because I just got started here. And the problems that you see in this page are basically having three levels of difficulty. So there are easy problems, there are medium, and there are hard. And what I would recommend is if you're a beginner, if you're just getting started with programming, look at only the easy problems. Try to solve a few easy problems. Once you get comfortable with that, only then move into medium and then finally to the hard problems. From my personal experience, what I have seen so far is that some of the easy problems are really easy, so you can solve it, but some of the easy problems are also pretty hard to solve. And I'm going to tell you how you can solve them as well. Also, instead of searching for a problem based on difficulty level, I can also search for it based on the top 100 liked questions. So if I go here list and just choose top 100 liked questions, so these are the most famous 100 questions in this website. You can click on that and only those questions will show up. Or let's say if I wanted to look for questions which are the top interview questions, I can click on that and this will show me all the top interview questions here. So these are the few filters that you can apply to search for the questions that you want. Also, you can search questions based on specific topics. So let's say you are looking for questions related to strings. You can just search for that and all the questions related to strings would show up. So these are the few options when you are trying to search for a problem. If I wanted to search for a SQL problem, okay, so what I can do is I can just type SQL here. And then you would see all the different problems that I can solve using SQL queries. There are a few. I can see around 50 here. So I think those are only the SQL queries. So let's say if I just get into any one of the questions. So I just go here, nth highest salary. It will show up something like this. And on the right-hand side is where I need to write my query or my program. So you can read the question here. So it's telling write a query to get the nth highest salary from the employee table. This is the table with the data, and there are some additional information that you need to follow. So this is basically the question that you need to solve, and you need to write your SQL query or programs here. And then when you're writing, you have a few options here. So if you want to solve this problem using Oracle, you can use Oracle. But if you are comfortable using MySQL or MS SQL Server, then you can use any of the RDBMS that you prefer, until and unless those options show up here. So this is how you can solve SQL questions. Once you write the question, you can just run the code. And if the code is proper, it's going to tell it's accepted. And then finally, you can submit the code. Once you have submitted the code and once it is approved, it will mark it like you have solved this question. Okay. So now if I go back to problems, and if I show you some problems related to which you can solve using Python or Java, let's see how it looks. So I'm here, and let's say if I want to just search based on, okay. So let's say if I wanted to search, okay, this problem, zigzag conversion. So if I click on that, you can see that it's basically some problem. It's telling the string, this one is written in zigzag pattern on a given number of rows like this. You may want to display this pattern in a fixed font for better legibility. Okay. Now, this is a kind of a question that you will need to solve, and you will need to write a program to solve this. So you can solve this problem using several different programming languages. So you have the options here. So you have Python 3, but if you prefer Java, you can choose Java, or if you choose C hash, you can choose C hash, etc. So depending on which programming language you want to solve the problem, you will see the options here, and based on that you can fix it. So once you again the same thing, you once you write your program, you can just run your code, and if it is accepted, then you can submit it. Once it is submitted and once it is approved, it will tell that your questions has been you have solved the problem. But let's say you are looking at a problem and you are stuck and you don't know what to do. In that case, you also have the option of looking at the solution. Okay, so when it comes to the solution, what the best part about this LeetCode is that you will have multiple solutions to the same problem. So here you can see this approach one, and it's telling sort by row. So they will explain you what is the algorithm and what is the thinking behind solving this problem, what kind of method that you can apply. And this is the first approach. You can also see there is a second approach which you can apply to solve the same problem. And also, you can see that these problems, the solutions are given in Java and C++ only. But then let's say if you wanted to solve this problem using Python 3, okay, then you don't have to worry. You can just go down and look for the comments. So you can see there are 210 comments, and almost whatever I have seen, all the problems, you would always find a solution for Python as well. So as for example, you can see a solution that is given by here. I'm not sure if it's going to work or not, but there are several different solutions for each of the programming language that you can find in the comment section. And if you don't find it here, you can also look for in the discuss tab here. So here you would generally find a solution to a problem. So if I just click on this Python solution, this is a program. So these are the solutions to the problem which someone else has already solved. But what I would recommend is, do not look at the solution straight away. First, try to solve the problem on your own. But let's say if you are completely stuck, you don't know what to do, then go into solutions tab and read the algorithm and read the approach, how you can solve it. Even after reading through it, if you don't get any idea, and only then look for the code. If you found this video useful, then please make sure to like the video and also subscribe to the channel. And also leave a comment on what you think about this website, LeetCode. Thank you and happy learning. See you in the next one.